Hello everyone, I'm Sam, one of your school liaison officers here at Blackpool and the Fylde College, and today I'm stood in our Construction Skills Centre. We've recently had a major renovation of our Construction Skills Centre, creating the largest Construction Skills Centre in the Northwest. And I'm happy to say that I'm joined today by one of our programme leaders here in construction. We are here today with Ling Sang. Thank you ever so much for being with me today.
Thank you, Sam, for having me.
It's really kind of you to give us your time. I know everyone's really, really busy here. Obviously, it looks like a building site. You know, it's one of those bustling industries here and one of our sort of prized curriculum areas, we should say, here at Blackpool and the Fylde College. You yourself actually were a student here at one point and you've progressed on to being a tutor.
Yeah.
All of our tutors here are what we'd say are industry specialists. So what was your journey from student to tutor?
Yeah, absolutely. So I joined college, this college environment, when I was 19. So I was a little bit older than some of the typical apprentices that you'd find at 16. But I did finish at St Mary's sixth form and did my A-levels as well. And I focused on art. But I thought, oh, I want to apply that art skill into a more practical job. So I decided to do painting and decorating. So I gained an apprenticeship with a local company and I progressed from level 1, 2, 3 through the decorating apprenticeship and got to work all over the Northwest on government buildings, private buildings, got to travel with it, absolutely loved it. But for me, it was always a stepping stone up to the next level. So I then progressed into HND in construction and the built environment. And then from there, I actually started teaching alongside me doing that course. So I did some hours in the decorating department and started to really enjoy the teaching aspect of it. And then I progressed into my teaching qualification straight after my HND, but having had a little bit of teaching experience in the background. So from there, I started off as a lecturer one. I did sort of like part-time hours. I was an instructor demonstrator. And then as the years have progressed and my experience has grown, I guess, I've progressed to senior tutor teaching learning assessments, supporting staff in their planning and teaching and learning. And then my particular programme needed a leader. So I felt like given my experience in that department that I would take that role. So now that's why I'm program leader of that department. Obviously, alongside this, I have a couple of businesses too. So lots of transferable skills that I've learned along the way has allowed me to sort of progress outside of college as well in my own businesses. But yeah, that's as much as I'm at. Yeah. At the moment. Is that okay?
No, it's great. No, it's absolutely brilliant. I mean, what I love about that is that it demonstrates, particularly here in construction, that you've gone from the very beginning all the way through on different course levels. Because I think what's important for prospective students to know mm-hmm. is that, well, first off, you yourself said you started off doing art.
Yes.
And people may not think of doing art at school, mm-hmm. maybe at GCSE level, and thinking, oh, I'm going to maybe transfer that into a construction career. So that's amazing.
Yeah.
But also that you've gone from the very, very beginning here and you've built, without using a terrible pun, now that we're in the Construction Skills Centre, you've built the foundations yeah. of your career. I think what's important for prospective students is knowing that in construction here at college, you do have to start off pretty much at the beginning.
Absolutely,
and yeah. build your way up through the level one, the two and the three courses.
Absolutely, you can't assume that you have those basic skills. So you start at level one to gain those basic skills and that sets you up for year two and year three, which become obviously much more advanced craft levels, particularly in decorating. I in third year, I did specialist decorative effects. So we did wood graining, marbling, gilding, which is your gold leafing, which are very traditional types of specialist effects. And you wouldn't do that at level one because we need to know, first of all, how to prepare surfaces, how to apply paint correctly, which is the most appropriate for the surface that we're using. So those basics have to be there before we move up the levels, but there are exciting things at each level to get to, you know, try out.
Sure.
And I very much enjoyed the practical aspect of it. Whilst I am academic, I really like sort of getting stuck in and getting a bit covered in paint yeah. and getting a bit dirty, I suppose.
Well,
you know what I mean? That's the whole point, isn't it?
That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
So what's interesting about that as well, Ling, is that you were an apprentice as well.
Yes.
For prospective students who maybe wondering about apprenticeships, do you mind explaining a little bit your journey into that? How do you come about, let's say, if you're looking at construction, getting into an apprenticeship? Because construction would be maybe one of those industries where an apprenticeship is very beneficial, you know, because you're getting that hands-on experience.
Yeah. I mean, just before I do talk about that, my whole career has been around learning on as you go, learning on the job. So you could almost look at my teaching career as an apprenticeship, because I was studying while teaching at that time, obviously back when I was studying it. But as a decorator, you know, I was coming to college on block release. So I'd get to spend time on site for a month, come to college for a couple of weeks. I get paid the whole time for being there or here. And then in year two, we were able to sort of do longer on site, shorter at college, to the point where when we got to level three, we were just in college on a Monday and the rest of the time we were on site. So all that experience was absolutely amazing to develop us in terms of real life skills in the industry. Go back to the question, please.
No, it's cool. It's more about obviously that journey that you've gone on. So if you're an apprentice or you're thinking and considering about doing an apprenticeship in construction, where do you start with that? You know, what does a student have to go out and find and look for?
Yeah, absolutely. So, I mean, when I was looking for my apprenticeship, there wasn't Yell.com. There was the good old Yellow Pages. So what I did was I got the Yellow Pages out and, you know, looked at all of the painting, decorating companies that stood out to me. And I did actually ring a list of employers and asked if they were interested in taking an apprentice. And I'm very much in that mindset of if you don't ask, you don't get. So for me, it was like, be brave, pick up that phone, ask the question, and you never know, they might like you, you know, over the phone. At which point I was invited for an interview with BTS Decorators Limited, and I was basically started the week after. Yeah, I got picked up in the van and that was me, and I learned on the job. I was off.
Well, I think that's an amazing story, because I think what we try and encourage anyway, even though we can assist students in finding an apprenticeship, is that going out there yourself at that age, it builds your confidence, mm-hmm. it builds your employability skills, because you're having to interact with companies and businesses, you're selling yourself. And it's building that resilience, because you may get turned down for things, and you know, you've just got to know that, you know, that opportunity and chance will come for you.
Absolutely, don't give up. That's the main thing.
Brilliant.
Keep persevering.
So how did college then come into to that element of your apprenticeship? Because obviously mm-hmm. you do about 80%, as you say, you spend most of your time in the week on site and maybe mm-hmm. one day a week at college. So how does the college element sort of sit next to the apprenticeship on the job training?
Well, basically, I got my placement in the August of 2006. So I started my college course with alongside CITB in the September. I'd worked on site in the summer holidays to obviously gain that experience before I then went on to studying the theory aspect at college. Now, we have amazing facilities here, and they have been upgraded, as you can see. But at the time, we also still had brilliant facilities that we were able to do simulations of rooms, paper around light fittings, test out oil-based paints, water-based paints. So we weren't just coming to college to do the theory, but we were also doing it to practice our hand skills as well. And we were learning, I mean, my tutors back then were so, you know, obviously so talented, so interesting, and really inspiring as well, that obviously that enthused me to carry on in their footsteps, really.
No, that's brilliant. And then you, within this industry, you can then progress with us if you want to, even if you're an apprentice, onto a degree level course.
Absolutely.
Which is, I believe, it's a higher national certificate, isn't it, in construction in the built environment. So how does that work? How does that translate, you know, because you could do your apprenticeship and you could just go off into the world of work.
Yeah, of course.
What's the benefit of staying on with us and going on to that degree level program?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. Progression is key, isn't it? So never stop to learn more and work up the levels. So yeah, you can do your level three levels of your apprenticeship, and you can go out into the world. You could have your own van, you could do your own business, you could go down that route, and you could come back to us in a few years' time, or you could stay with us up to level three and go straight into our level four higher national certificate, which we call the HNC in construction and the built environment. And with that, it's a part-time course, and it's highly demanded by people in the industry, because it's one day a week, which allows obviously adults to maintain their family lives, their work lives, alongside studying. But a lot of our local companies recognise that HNC, and they are looking for that when there are people are applying for jobs in the industry as well. So it's a great way to get your foot in the door. Now, as part of that course as well, we have lots of industry experts giving us like virtual guest speaker opportunities. We've obviously had lots of site visits. We've had work placements attached to that. We've had job offers because they've really enjoyed our students and the standards, obviously, that we're sort of giving to the industry. So it's not just about studying in the classroom, it's about talking to people and learning from people in industry as well. And we do have lots of contacts. And we've even got students who left us 5 years ago who are coming back to us now and doing virtual guest speaker talks with us and our students. And it's absolutely fantastic.
That's amazing. It's paying it forward, really, to those
students.
Yeah, and
I've already warned my students this year that I will be contacting them in 5 years' time.
No, that's brilliant. I think it's great because it keeps that connection as well. And it allows us as a college to bring in expertise from all different areas, no matter what they go into, you know. We do have some amazing links, you know, we work with some great partners and that really helps people. Do you mind me asking as well, from your perspective, what I think is amazing as well for prospective students out there, and I'm thinking more of our female prospective students here, is that they can have a look around here in the Construction Skills Centre and, you know, you said yourself, you like getting hands-on, you don't mind getting dirty. Some people maybe sort of think to themselves, you know, being a bricklayer or a plasterer, it's dirty, being a painter decorator. But there's a lot of scope within the industry for creative minds, and in particular, you know, for females in the industry as well, to come in and either be super hands-on or develop their skills within within the construction area.
Absolutely.
What sort of advice do you have for those females?
The reason why I became a decorator is I wanted to start from the beginning. I wanted to physically learn about the skills and know that I could do it. And for me, it was that was something I had to prove to myself as a female as well. But as a person, I wanted to know what it felt like to get mucky, to be covered in wallpaper paste, you know, work crazy hours and things like that. But know that I produced that and I that finish, that quality finish, I did that and be proud of it. In terms of females, and females tend to be a little bit more, tend to have an eye for detail, a bit cleaner in terms of sort of cleaning up and tidying. And I think as well, that makes it a little bit more accessible for different people, different clients who maybe feel a little bit more comfortable with a lady doing the decorating as well. But there's absolutely no reason why girls could do it. I've worked with females last 14 years in the industry. And what I've found as well, where you've got one female to a group of lads, they stand out. Yeah. They stand out because we have to prove ourselves amongst the boys that actually we're good, if not better. And that is the attitude I have.
Well, I think that's absolutely brilliant. And I think what's so nice is that here at the college, prospective students can look to people like you being their tutor and having that enthusiasm, having that guidance to help propel them on their career. And sort of talking about careers again, you know, again, coming back to the room we're in, you know, we can see here, you know, people setting out their different projects in terms of bricklaying and building. Up and around us, we've got the plastering booths. We do have rooms here for woodwork. There's a lot of hands-on bits and pieces, and people may just think it's bricklayer, plumber, plasterer, electrician. But there's so much more to construction than that, isn't there?
Absolutely. And as well, if the student decides to progress from level 3 to level 4, it opens up a whole new world of careers. It's not just trade, which is what you've just described, but there are jobs in quantity surveying, in architecture and design, computer-aided design. These days we've got building information modelling. We're in a digital world now. So there's jobs around that and massive career and massive salaries. You know, with building surveying, conservation, there's so many other professional, really interesting jobs to do that aren't physically, you know, getting mucky as such. But there are, you know, there are jobs that you are on site and you're in the office and you get to travel a little bit. You might go to different sites. But there are, like I say, loads of progression routes from there. And it doesn't stop there either. So there are professional bodies within the industry too. So we have the Royal Institute of British Architects, the best of the best. We've got the Royal Institute of Chartered Surveyors as well. So it doesn't stop even at getting your degree. You can then work towards your chartership and become the best of the best. And that is something that, to me, you know, you just want, who wouldn't want that?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's massively, massively inspiring. Yeah.
And obviously with that becomes a better reputation, higher wage band, more work, you know what I mean? And
so it's just the sky's the limit, really.
Yeah, absolutely.
No, that's amazing. Well, Link, thank you ever so much for being with me today to talk all about it. You know, your enthusiasm, you know, comes to me at this socially distanced element. You know, hopefully for prospective students looking at construction, you know, they will be really inspired by this. So thank you so much for your time. If you are interested in more information about what you can do here at Blackpool and the Fylde College in our construction department, do check out our website. That's blackpool.ac.uk. You can find our entire course list there for all of our construction elements. If you want information on our construction apprenticeships or to get more information going further in progression onto our degree level programmes, it's all located there. If you want to apply to us as well, we highly recommend that. put an application in online. Just find your preferred course and click the apply button. But from me for now, take care. Bye-bye.